गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, सत्यम वदा धर्मचरा सत्यमेव जयते। वेलकम टुडे न्यूज डेस्क ऑन इनकम टैक्स जीएसटी एंड कॉर्पोरेट लॉ। लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द इनकम टैक्स। मद्रास हाई कोर्ट सेक्शन 14A दिस अलाउंस वैलिड एज एसेसी स्टूडेंट सबस्टेंशिएट एक्ट दैट नॉन एक्सपेंडिचर वाज इंकर्ड टू अर्न एग्जेम्प्ट इनकम। इन दिस केस मद्रास हाई कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट where SSC company claimed that no expenditure was incurred to earn exempt income under section 14A, this allowance was not called for, but it could not substantiate that fact before lower authority, and it was found that there was substantial increase in investment and value of the assets of the SSC. Assessing officer was justified in making this allowance under section 14A. Read with the rule 8B. CBDT order dated 25th September 2020. CBDT sets up NFAC and RFAC under the Faceless Appeal Scheme 2020. Notify income tax authorities as well. In this order, CBDT has notified the income tax authorities which shall exercise the powers and functions in order to facilitate the conduct of faceless appeal proceedings. The board has also set up National Faceless Appealing Center and Regional Faceless Appealing Center for Faceless Appeal in 2020. Next is Jaipur Tribunal mere debiting amount by way of the general entry does not affect deemed dividend provision. In this case, for invoking provision of section 2 clause 22E, there must be a payment by way of advance or loan. Hence, where this vital aspect was missing in case of the SSC, as neither there was any payment nor company made any advance or loan to SSC, thus debit balance worked out by the SSC company will not fall within the ambit of the provision of section 2 clause 22E and thus are not applicable in case of the SSC. Next case, Madras High Court. Only those expenses which was proved to be incurred relating to the earning of the exempt income to be disallowed. In terms of section 14A, only expenditure which was proved to be incurred in relation to earning of the tax-free income could be disallowed, and such provision could not be extended to disallow expenditure which was assumed to have been incurred for earning tax free income. To apply provision of section 14A, assessing officers could have recorded a finding as to how subsection 1 of section 14A could have stand extracted. In absence of any such finding, this allowance made was not justifiable. Mumbai Tribunal, discount offered by the Tata Sky to the distributor and subscriber can't be considered as discount for the section 194(8) CDS. In this case, where the SSC engaged in the business of providing DTH services and sold setup box and hardware and discharge coupon voucher to distributors at a discounted rate, and also provided certain discount or bonus or credit to the customer or subscriber for taking subscription directly from the company website, discount so offer could not be considered as commission and hence not liable for deduction of tax as source under provision of section 194(8). In this case, also held that where the SSC made an ad hoc provision for the expenditure in respect of the sale promotion, legal and professional fee, interest and programming cost, but did not pay TDS on the same. In fact, this allowance made under section 14AIA was justified. Where the SSC had filed necessary evidence to prove availability of its own fund, which were sufficient to cover investment made by the SSC in capital work in progress during the year, interest paid on borrowed fund was to be allowed under section 36 of section 1C. And next decision held in this case, where there was no exempt income earned by the SSC during the year, no disallowance under section 14A above. CVDT issued press release on the 26th September 2020. In this press release, a space while reporting in the IPR is required only if long-term capital gains are eligible for grant tethering. CVDT held a clarify in this press release that the main intent behind requiring the space while reporting in the income tax return is to facilitate the taxpayer in correctly computing the long-term capital gain on sale of the shares or units. But there is no such mandatory requirement to furnish script-wise details of the sale of the shares in the return of income for assessment year 2020-21. Let's cover news on the international taxation. Madras High Court remanded matter back to the assessing official as SSC had raised issue relating to the double taxation avoidance agreement first time before the court. Their issue relating to the section 90 of the income tax act read with the double taxation avoidance agreement between India and USA had not been raised before the assessing official or before commissioner appeals or before tribunal. But for first time, SSC had raised issue before this court, and that issue had also been raised in the substantial question of the law. Occasion to deal with the said issue in this tax case appeal did not arise. CVDT press release 25th September, government to study Vodafone arbitration case reward and take decision on further course of action. The finance minister ministry has said that it will be studying the arbitration case passed in favor of the Vodafone International Holding BV against government of the India. The government will consider all options and take a decision on further course of action, including legal remedies before appropriate court. Let's start GST update. Delhi High Court, tax rate cannot be challenged in a court of the law unless it is a confiscatory in nature. Delhi High Court held in this case that rate of tax could not have been challenged in a court of law unless it was evidently confiscatory in nature, thus thereby nothing had been argued out about how present rate of the GST on mask and sanitizer was confiscatory in law. Merely because petitioner felt that GST rate applied on mask and sanitizer was excessive, this could not be reason for issuing a writ of the mandamus and directing responded to reduce tax on said commodity. Further, what items are to be included under Essential Commodities Act 1955 as essential commodity is a policy decision of the respondent or government, and therefore, unless such decision could be shown to be the manifestly unreasonable or arbitrarily, High Court could not interfere with the policy decision of the government. Hence, the writ of the mandamus to direct respondent to same notification dated 13th March 2020 to include mask and sanitizer as essential commodities under Essential Commodities Act 1955 and could not have been allowed. AR Gujarat ruling, mechanical liquid dispenser made of the plastic is classifiable under heading 3926 liable to 18% GST. Another case, Kerala High Court, sale of goods to the outbound passenger by duty-free shop qualify as a export ITC refund is available. Kerala High Court held in this day's case that in respect of the denial of the refund on supply made by duty-free shop DFS to outbound passenger, the Kerala High Court held that supply of the goods by the DFS qualifies as export of goods and refund is available on such supply. AR Gujarat product micro manipulator system are classifiable under the heading 99011 taxable asset of the 18% GST. Another advance authority ruling, Rajasthan. Collection of the entry fee for the municipal park and ticket charger for toy train or boat facility in park attracts 18% GST. Another advance authority ruling, Karnataka. Maintaining main facility with respect to resident dwelling by housing society from amount charged from the members in this service. In this ruling, where the applicant house building cooperative society is engaged in development and sale of the site to its members for housing, it is held that activity of the maintenance of the layout by applicant from funds collected from the members of the society amounts to supply in terms of Section 7, Section 1A and attract GST and entry number 77 of the notification number 12/2017. Central tax rate dated 28th June 2017 is applicable to applicant only to extent of amount of the rupees 7,500 per month per member collected by way of the reimbursement of the charges of share or contribution for sourcing of the goods or services from a third person for common use of its members. AR Kerala plastic latex collection cup exclusively used for the rubber tapping is an agricultural implement exempted from the GST. Plastic latex collection cup is an agricultural implement exclusively used for the rubber tapping classifiable under heading 8201-9000 and is exempt from the GST. There are many circular announced yesterday in company law. So MCA General Circular 33/2020 dated 28 September. Now companies can conduct board and general meeting virtually till 31st December 2020 due to COVID-19 outbreak. MCA has extended the relation to the companies for conducting their meeting virtually till 31st December 2020. Another circular 32/2020, MCA extends timelines for a scheme for the relaxation of the time for filing of the forms on creation or modification of the charge. In order to provide spare time to the companies, the MCA extended the due date of scheme issued for the relaxation of the time for filing forms related to the creation and modification of the charges under Companies Act till 31st December 2020. Another general circular, MCA extend company phase start scheme 2020 and LLP scheme 2020 till 31st December 2020. Due to COVID-19 outbreak, the MCA had provided a one-time relaxation for companies and LLP to save them from making additional fees payment on account of the reporting delays. Now it has been decided to extend the last date for the scheme till 31st December 2020. Under SEBI circular dated 28 September, issued that SEBI amend guidelines for preferential issues and institutional placement of the units listed by the INV, ITs and REIT, real estate institutional in view of the situation emerging of the COVID-19 pandemic, the market regulator SEBI has granted certain relaxation for raising equity capital. On similar lines, the stand guidelines for preferential issue and institutional placement of the units of by listed NVITs and REITs has been modified as set out. So thank you so much for watching News Desk on the income tax, GST and corporate law. We are trying to cover all updates, including case law and circular notification guidelines on income tax, GST and corporate law on daily basis. So please subscribe our channel for regular updates on the income tax, GST, corporate law, international taxation, transfer pricing, FEMA, FCRA, and other alloyed laws. Thank you so much for watching this news channel. Thank you.